Hello everyone. In this video session, I am going to provide answer for one of the Java interview questions. That is, write a Java program to find the largest number. We need to write a Java program to find the largest number. In the provided numbers list, we have to find the largest number. So how to write a program? First of all, let's say we were given with some numbers. Let's say they have given us some numbers like 9. Okay, 12, some 5, 16, okay, then 7, then 99, then 123 and 45. Like this, some numbers were given, let's say, okay, 9, 12, 5, 16, 7, 99, 123 and some random numbers, guys. Now, when you are given these numbers and you are asked to find the largest number, first thing that you have to do is you have to create a variable, say A, and declare this variable as integer array so that this variable can store all these numbers. In a single variable, you can store all these numbers, guys. So let's store 9 comma 12 comma 5 comma 16 comma 7 comma 99 comma 123 comma 45. Like this, all the numbers are stored into the variable A, which is of integer array type. Now we need to write the logic. The logic is very simple, guys. So first we have to say int max is equal to 0. Okay, so we are going to find the maximum or largest number, okay, and store into this max variable. Initially I am setting this max or largest number to 0, guys. Okay, and I will compare this max with all these numbers one by one and see if any other number is more than this max, then I will try to assign this numbers to this max. Okay, finally at the end of the program, this max should contain the largest number out of all these numbers, right? That is the thing. Now for this, we need to write a for loop. For, because I need to iterate through all the numbers, right? So I have to write a for loop. For int I is equal to 0, I less than what, guys? The length of the array. How many numbers are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, we can either give 8 or we can give a dot length. Both are same. Then I plus plus. Okay, then I plus plus, guys. Then here, open and close the for loop. And inside the for loop, we need to write a logic, guys. Okay, inside the for loop, we need to write a simple logic, very simple logic. You have to write something like, if this particular max, okay, sorry. So if, let me write again. If this particular max, okay. If max is less than any of these numbers, okay, one by one, okay, if max is less than the number, so a of I, the first iteration a of I will become a of 0, right? That's the logic is, if max is less than a of I, then assign the value of a of I to max. Okay, if max is less than a of I, then assign the value that is stored in the a of I to the max, so max will become bigger than that number, right? That's why we are saying if max is less than I, make the max equal to a of I. Otherwise, don't assign this a of I to max. When max is greater than a of I, you are not going to assign. But when max is less than a of I, then you are going to assign the value that is there in the a of I to the max. So this is the logic, guys. This is a simple logic. So let's see what will happen when we run this program. Very simple, guys. When you run this logic, so first of all, okay, for int I is equal to 0, I will be 0, guys. The value of I is 0 now. Okay, it is 0. Now next thing is 0 less than a dot length. 0 less than a dot length. What is a dot length? The length of the array. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay. Here a dot length is nothing but 8, guys. Okay, this value is 8. Current value is 8. Now max is 0, guys. Max is 0. So here what will happen is, so here int I is equal to 0, I will become 0 now, like this. And I less than a dot length. 0 less than a dot length is 8. 0 less than 8 is true or false? True. So we'll go inside the for loop. Then this condition will be verified. If max is less than a of I, max is currently 0, guys. Max is currently 0. 0 less than a of I, a of 0. A of I means a of 0. Current value of I is 0. So a of 0. 0 less than a of 0. A of 0 means what? First element, that is 9. 0 less than 9. Yes, it is correct. So it will go inside the if condition, if block, and max will become a of I. That means max earlier was 0, and from 0 max will be assigned with a new value, that is new biggest or largest value, that is the next largest value 9 will be assigned. Now max is currently 9. Now after this, again the for loop, we'll go back to the for loop, and I will become I++. I will become from 0 to 1, guys. So from 0 I will be incremented by 1. That means I will become 1 here. Now 1 less than a dot length, 1 less than 8, true or false? Again true. We'll go inside the for loop. Max less than a of I, again this condition will be verified. Current value of max is 9. 9 less than 12. A of I is 12, right? Here I became 1. A of 1 means 12, guys. Okay, here max is 9. 9 less than this 12. 9 will be compared with this 12. Yeah, 9 is really less than 12. That's true. So max will become 12 now. Max will become 12 now. So like this, we keep on continuing, guys. Okay, in the next iteration again, I will become 2. Okay, from I1 to, it will become 2. I will become 2. 2 less than 8, again true. We'll go inside. Current value of max is 12. 12 less than 5, false. So max is equal to a of I will not be executed. Again, I will become 3 this time. I will become 3. So I will become 3. So when I is 3, 3 less than 8 is true. Again, max is currently 12. 12 less than 16. Okay. A of I, that is A of 3 is 16. So 12 less than 16 is again true. So max will become 16. Max will become 16, guys. So like this, the logic will be executed, guys. So now again, I will become 4. I will become 4. I becomes 4. So 4 less than 8 is again true. Max is currently 16. 16 less than 7 is false. So it will not be done. Then I will become 5. If it is greater, okay, if the given number is given array number is largest than the maximum number, then only max stored number, then only max will be assigned with that largest number. Otherwise it will be not assigned. That's a simple funda, guys. 5 less than 8 is true. Max is 16. 16 less than 99. Yes, it is correct. So max will become 699. Okay, max will become 99, guys. Max became 99. Now again I will become 6. I will be incremented to 1. That is, I will become 6. Now 6 is less than 8 and max is less than 99 is less than 123. Again true. Max will become 123. So we are getting the max variable to upgrade to the largest number. To get upgraded to the largest number. Now I will become 7. I will become 7. So 7 less than 80, again true. So max less than a of I. Max is currently 123. 123 less than 45. Is it true? No, guys. So max will not be assigned. So the maximum number so far is 123. I will become 8. Finally, I will become 8. So now the condition, I less than a dot length, 8 less than a dot length, 8 less than 8 is true or false? False. So we'll come out of the for loop. Finally, max is left with which number? 123. This number, if you print right, you will get the maximum number out of all these numbers. So 123 is the largest number of all these numbers. So guys, hope you understood it in a theoretical way here, but let's write down this code in the editor, one of the editor, and see whether we are getting the same output that I explained here. We should get the 123 as the output. So here I'll create a variable and declare this variable with integer array. A is equal to, I have to give the same numbers. I will give the same numbers, 9 comma 12 comma 5 comma 16 comma 7 comma 99 comma 123 comma 45. Okay, all these are the numbers. So we have this all this list of numbers stored into the variable A. Now I'll create a variable max and assign this with some sample or default value as 0. Now I'll write the logic, like for int I is equal to 0, I less than a dot length I++. I++ I will say. Now here, I'll write the logic like if max is less than a of I, if max is less than a of I, then what I'm going to do? I'm going to assign the max with the a of I, the largest number, the next possible largest number I am assigning to the max if this condition is true. So after all these iterations are done, here I will print the maximum number. Okay, the largest number is, what is the largest number, guys? That is nothing but plus max. This will have the largest number after this for loop iteration. So save this. Now right click on demo.java and say run as Java application. You see the largest number is 123 got displayed here. That means this program is working fine, guys. So guys, this is how we need to answer for this question, where we need to write a Java program to find the largest number. So that's it, guys. See you in the next video session. Thank you. Bye.